Now you're very welcome this morning in a beautiful sunny Newcastle West in County Limerick, and what better scenery and people could you want? Now this is the What Matters programme with myself, John Prendergast, and this morning I'm in the company of a great man in my eyes and many people's eyes, Jim Barrett from Newcastle West. Jim, good morning to you. It's great to be with you here.
Good morning, John. How are you? Thank you.
Now, as we can see, the backdrop is fantastic bikes.
Thank you.
Which actually frightened me, because if I went up on one, I'd probably collapse. But I see so many people now around the country with cycling pursuits, and the wonderful scenery that we have and the safe roadways into the countryside is fantastic. Now, Jim, you're setting up and have set up a company called Pedal Pursuits Biker. Now, how did this all come about?
Setting up Pedal Pursuits Biker, I suppose, started in 2013. And actually, before that, we were GS Cycle Hire. Now, we took with some marketing with advice, and we changed it to Pedal Pursuits in 2013. So we registered in 2013. And we've been servicing, which was then the Great Southern Trail, then Great Southern Greenway, and so on, up to now. And as it's been a tough experience, but a great experience. And I met a lot of good people and communities, and I've worked with a lot of tourism businesses. So, yeah, it has been educational and a great thing as well.
Now, there is an ongoing matter with the Limerick City and County Council. Now, just explain what that is about. Now, you're very welcome this morning in a beautiful sunny Newcastle West in County Limerick. And what better scenery and people could you want? Now, this is the What Matters programme with myself, John Prendergast, and this morning I'm in the company of a great man, in my eyes and many people's eyes, Jim Barrett from Newcastle West. Jim, good morning to you. It's great to be with you here.
Good morning, John. How are you? Thank you.
Now, as we can see, the backdrop is fantastic bikes.
Thank you.
Which actually frightened me, because if I went up on one, I'd probably collapse. But I see so many people now around the country with cycling pursuits, and the wonderful scenery that we have and the safe roadways into the countryside is fantastic. Now, Jim, you're setting up and have set up a company called Pedal Pursuits Biker. Now, how did this all come about?
Setting up Pedal Pursuits Biker, I suppose, started in 2013. And actually, before that, we were GS Cycle Hire. Now, we took with some marketing with advice, and we changed it to Pedal Pursuits in 2013. So we registered in 2013. And we've been servicing, which was then the Great Southern Trail, in the Great Southern Greenway, and so on, up to now. And as it's been a tough experience, but a great experience. And I met a lot of good people and communities, and I've worked with a lot of tourism businesses. So, yeah, it has been educational and a great thing as well.
Now, there is an ongoing matter with the Limerick City and County Council. Now, just explain what that is about.
Well, look, it's important people know facts here. And we'll start off with this process started on the 5th of January 2021. Now, we entered that process and we went through the different process involved in that. And it has been, I suppose, a protracted process, as in we are here near the end of May and it's still, we say, unsolved. And we say, what we are saying here is that the, so we started, we followed this process, procurement process, and we followed all that was required. We tried to submit as much, everything that we required by Limerick County Council. Anything that we weren't sure of, there was, I suppose, issues around that, we looked for clarification, and we would have got some clarification on different things. But regarding the process and going into it in a bigger way, I can't, because of a legal issue and legal representation I have at this point in time.
And that's a separate issue at this point in time.
Now, regarding the actual the process and what Limerick County Council wanted for all of this was three locations, Rakeel, Newcastle West and Ebbyfield.
Right.
The initial process was that you get, we say, a front, we say, of the, we say, the buildings there, we say, shop front. Now, you'd have to supply that as, we say, the temporary for the first 2 years, and yes, after that, you were working on a lease and so on. But anyway, we are here, I suppose, and we are offering a service for a long time, and we were looking into the process, but we were a little bit confused, because, you know, business is a natural thing, and where there's customers, things develop.
Of course.
Then, you know, people be watching that, and that's what we have been doing, and as if we took a chance, I suppose. There's a lot of things there have been said, and a lot of misinformation, and Limerick County Council are quoting that a lot. But actually, it is those guys that are actually spreading misinformation. Because, for example, is that, as you can see there, we have a shuttle bus there.
Yes, that's a cool it's a vehicle. Fine bus.
Yeah, and we've offered that since we began 2013.
Yes.
Limerick County Council would know that information because we've actually have supplied bikes to Limerick County Council down through the years for different events when ministers will be announcing a different allocation of funding and so on. So yeah. They would know that. And when we submitted our application, not alone that, we actually submitted our insurance to back that up as well.
Of course.
So they would know that. But they have been saying that there is a limited bike hire service and actually no shuttle bus service. No, that is totally incorrect. This bus is here, insured, and been offered for the last 8 years. So that will have to be addressed by Limerick City County Council at this stage. Just for one part, section of this will have to be addressed. And as I say, there's a big social media campaign at this point in time, signatures and so on, and there's over 700 signatures now. And it's very clear what people want. And they're telling me continuously is that they want this investigated. They want this process stopped. They want everyone that has been involved in it to explain why this was initiated and why it was rolled out. And I suppose the county councillors will have to explain why they voted for it.
Well, they have a duty to do it.
You would imagine so.
To the taxpayers.
Yeah, because this is not small time now.
No.
This is big time. This will absolutely skew the market. I'm here and I have got no funding. €350 I have received so far in 10 years. Now, to give any business €300,000...
It's a phone bill for 6 months.
It's 100%. And that's a turnover like that can't be matched. Do you know, that differential will never be closed in. You just can't, because they'll be so far ahead. And be mindful that we're watching Arda. Arda is wrapped in scaffolding this point in time. Don't be surprised if you see this company going into Arda, taking over Arda. That's four separate points in Limerick. Now, we all know that the Kerry section is going to be open next year. So what happens there? You have such a dominant company, they're going to take over Kerry. So
yes.
You have, you could say, a €15 million infrastructure handed to one business. Now, if that is not incorrect, or if that is not interfering with natural forces and markets, I don't know what is.
Well, what I can't understand, Jim, is, you see, we look to the council, we look to politicians to be educated, have common sense, foot on the ground, know what men and women are going to do to bring business to a locality, create a business, create maybe employment in the future. And there seems to be nothing but nonsensical issues. I mean, for somebody to turn around in the council and say there's no shuttle bus, and I'm looking at one here, showed me the inside, fully insured, everything done. I don't know what's going on.
It's very worrying. It's absolutely right, because that's not the only thing. Like, they have put, we'll say, demands on businesses when they were submitting the application. They just did not add up.
No.
The figures did not add up. We went to the Bank of Ireland. They could not. You wouldn't get a credit union loan on the back of what they were giving us. And like, I want people to know, and I would not wish it on anyone what I've gone through with the last 5 months. Because it's a constant strain. You're constantly trying to count on what they're looking for. And you know your business. It's like anyone, they know the business and they know what you need to do and how you need to develop it. And you're looking at it and they're telling you that this is how you do your business. You've been doing it all wrong now for the last, when we were, as I say, in 2018, like I've been involved in tourism, and in 2018, just the one of the contradictions, as chairman of Limerick County Council came to me looking for a letter of support for funding, for RRTP funding, which we gave. Now, Limerick County Council got €2.7 million for that. No, I'm not good enough in 2.5 years. And like, if that's the way we treat our people, community is going to be gone, because there'll be no point in community people getting involved and trying to support, because this is the end of it. This is what will happen to them. And it's very worrying, and it needs to be addressed now. And people, in fairness, people are standing up and people are angry. There's over 16,000 views on that page. I only set up a couple of days.
Good
and
man.
There's a lot of interest.
Well,
there's a lot of anger. And that cannot be ignored. And if Limerick County Council continues to ignore that, it's so the matter is only going to get worse. And that is the way it is.
It's very, very sad, because I know businesses that have actually closed because the government brought in this business back scheme during the pandemic. And they were so mitered, the businesses, men and women, with small businesses, medium businesses that were put through the loops, paperwork, paperwork, paperwork. They just gave it up and said, no use. It's a sham,
yeah,
a total sham. And here we have Limerick City and County Council that are supposed to be, well, they are elected by the people, and they're supposed to look after
people, yeah,
business men and women. And obviously this is a failure.
Yeah.
They're not.
Absolutely. And as I say, like, it's on their vans that they serve the people, and it's very important. And like,
yes,
people will say, they want to work with Limerick County Council. We all want to work with Limerick,
yes,
County Council. But it's very important that Limerick County Council hear what people are saying. And this is not, this is unique, by the way, to Limerick.
Yes.
No other Greenway have come on and actually done what Limerick County. Now, they have said, they have analysis, and they have done market research on this. Now, they've gone to Waterford and all these places, and this is not the norm. Natural progression, business see the potential, they take a chance, it might work out, it may not work out, but that's what a natural market is, and to interfere with it at this scale is just going to write it off completely, and we'll be all looking around and saying, what's after happening here? But now is the time to say, look, this is not right, we need to actually address this issue and see where, and the people involved, and there will be, look, if we work together and we have a transparent situation here and investigation,
yes,
we can move on after this, and everyone will be able to develop and create businesses and sustain businesses.
Well, you see, when the economy is opening up gradually, we want to get tourists in. We want to see Ardlin, Newcastle West, Abbeyfield thriving.
Of course.
Because all the small businesses, the local hotel here, the Long Court, I know so well, all the pubs will do well, all the coffee shops, the restaurants, right across the Midwest, all in this given area will thrive. You will thrive. Maybe you will need extra help.
Of course, yeah.
So you bring in somebody, a man or woman, with you to help you. That's employment. It's all there for the,
yeah,
taking, and all this bureaucracy right across the country is, yeah, such a damn nuisance.
It has. And look, as I say, this Greenway and look, is a community Greenway.
Yeah.
It has been secured by the Greenway, it has been developed and chased down, and it has been worked by the Greenway. And we have to look at all points to this. We said, Racky, we said, we're talking about the Greenway. They want bike, they want it fully sustained within the Greenway.
Yes.
Well, if we have a Greenway of that model, where are the towns and villages going to gain out of that? And we have a beautiful village there now that going to give bike
rides. Absolutely.
That should be a visitor centre for the other chalice.
Yes.
Let this village service with
the
bike.
It's there for taking. I did two interviews there recently with Billy McGuire and the Art of Chalice, and if you saw the signage for it, you'd pass it by.
You would, yeah.
It's there in the, yeah, taking. So imagine interlinking Arda, Newcastle West, Abbeyfield with the fantastic facilities here.
Yeah.
Sure, God.
It's just a given.
It's just a give.
It will. And like, that money could be put to, we said, the communities that are involved in that.
Absolutely.
And invested into businesses and villages like that. Like painting up the towns and painting up the shops and so on like that. And actually, when people see that, people will start to say, look, there's a business here somewhere. I'm going to start it. I'm going to take a chance. And the support should be into that. Not giving one business 300,000. It's a major, you know, boost for any business. And especially, as I say, we are not just closing it. If they want to come down and set up a business, absolutely. But don't give the assistance that we say that the rest of us aren't getting. Do you know what I mean?
Because I just wanted to ask you one question on that, about this loan. How did that come about, 300,000 loan?
It is a loan. It is. It's a capital loan.
Right.
And as I said that there's legal issues, and that,
yeah,
is,
so we leave that aside. So yeah, that's only fair.
And there is, now there's misinformation about that as well by Limerick County Council.
Right.
And that, you know, that we can't discuss at this point.
I love the bikes.
Yeah, look.
I'll tell you. Now, just to get the word out there, do you mind me asking one question? To ensure all of this for public safety and public liability, is that running into a couple of thousand a year?
We have, it is. We have public liability with FPD here in Newcastle,
yes,
for the bikes here, fully insured, along with the, as I say, the shuttle bus, which is fully insured.
Like
for
a package?
Yeah. Well, it's actually, they're separate really, but they're under the same
pedal
pursuits, because.